Young man, come here a second. I want to talk to you. Listen, you in high school, you look high school age, except you have that mustache, but I suppose, you know, 16-year-olds nowadays with the TikTok and the Instagram, I mean, the mustache is next, right? I mean, I tell you, for you, I think the mustache is a mistake, but it's okay, because, you know, I made mistakes when I was your age. Everyone makes mistakes, you know. When I was 16 and going to boarding school in the great state of Connecticut, during the Revolutionary War, of course, me and some boys would go into the city on the first day of vacation before splitting off to all our separate homes. And in the evening, we would go to this gin joint owned by the gangster father of one of us. And, of course, gangster, because this was during the Great Experiment, or as it's more formally known, Prohibition. Great time to be a gangster, not such a good time to be a liquor lobbyist. But anyway, we would go to this gin joint, and we would drink with the adults, and we would listen to the jazz. And this one time in the bunch of us, there was a boy, and he was about 15. And he had killed his mother with a shotgun some years before. Accidentally, completely accidentally. I have no doubt about that. No subconscious motivation or any of that. Complete accident. But he was with us, and when it came time to order our drinks, he said, "Can I have a Bergen, please? I would like a Bergen and water." And we just thought that was the funniest thing. I mean, oh, the whole place was laughing. The kid, he was blonde, he had white hair. And we started laughing, and the color rose to his face, and the blood rose up in his neck, and you could see he was embarrassed. And the assistant crook who took our order went and talked to the other table and told them what the kid had said, and they laughed, and then more people, and then more laughter, until the whole place was laughing at this kid. But no one was laughing as hard as us, and not one of us was laughing as hard as the kid who had killed his mother. And so, of course, we drank for free that night. We got a bottle of champagne from the gangster father of one of us. We paid for it the next day on our train rides home with our adult hangovers, you know, but look at me. That was the happiest day of my youth. I mean, truly. It was... Sorry, this is my bus. It's been good talking to you, young man. Listen, you have a light. Thank you, sir. Could you light it for me? Thank you. Good to know kids still know how to work a lighter. Well, last I heard of that boy, that 15-year-old boy who killed his mother with a shotgun, he was driving on a country road in Connecticut, his learner's permit in his left pocket and his father to his right, and he swerved to avoid hitting a gopher. And he ran straight into a tree, killed his father on the spot. But the gopher stayed alive. And, well, the kid walked out of the car, didn't know where he was, stumbled into a pile of roses and fell asleep. All right, well, see you next time.